Amen. Everybody got a Bible this morning? Hold them up, let me see them. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Take those Bibles and go to the book of Nehemiah this morning. Nehemiah chapter number 4. Nehemiah chapter number 4. We're going to read about 6 verses of scripture this morning. When everybody gets to Nehemiah chapter number 4, say amen.
Amen. Amen.
If you would, stand out of reverence for the reading of the Word of God. Nehemiah chapter 4, verses 1 through 6. But it came to pass that when Sanballat heard that we builded the wall, he was wroth and took great indignation and mocked the Jews. And he spake before his brethren and the army of Samaria and said, What to these feeble Jews? Will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they make an end in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of rubbish which are burned? Now Tobiah the Ammonite was by him, and he said, Even that which they build, if a fox go up, he shall even break down their stone wall. Hear, O our God, for we are despised, and turn their reproach upon their own head, and give them for prey in the land of captivity. And cover not their iniquity, and let not their sin be blotted out from before thee. For they have provoked thee to anger before the builders. So built we the wall. So built we the wall. And all the wall was joined together unto half thereof, for the people had a mind to work. So saith the word of God today. Father, bless us today with your word. Father, let this living and powerful word of yours, God, touch our lives and impact us, God, to convict us of all sin and righteousness in our lives, to draw us ever closer to you, God, to make a closer walk with you, God, to be encouraged, God, to go out and hold up your banner to this lost and dying world. God, we ask you, Lord, to let your Holy Spirit take control of this place now, Father God. Give us eyes to see, ears to hear, and hearts to receive what you have in store for us this day, Father. And God, I ask you, Lord, to bless me today, Father God, to forgive me where I failed you. Forgive me of my sin today, Father God. Cleanse me that I can stand before you right now above reproach to ask for your mercy and grace. Father God, I ask that your words would be my words, your thoughts my thoughts, your love in my heart, Jesus, that it flows out and touches everyone in this room. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We love you, Jesus. Amen and amen and amen. Give God a hand clap of praise and you may be seated. Amen. I want to give you some little bit of background on Nehemiah before we begin our message today. Nehemiah was an Israelite in the court of King Xerxes in the land of Persia. He was the king's cupbearer, and some of his brethren had come back from Jerusalem. There had been a group of Jews go back unto Ezra to rebuild the temple and to try to establish some semblance of life in Jerusalem, because Jerusalem had been destroyed. And as they came back, Nehemiah asked them about the condition of Jerusalem and the people there. And what he found out nearly broke his heart, because of the walls being torn down, the people in disarray and confusion. And as Nehemiah prayed, God put him on a path to go back and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. But I want to say this to you. When you begin to walk in obedience to the Lord, when you begin to try to accomplish something for His glory, to accomplish a task that He's called you to, I want to tell you today that the enemy will come against you.
Amen.
He's going to laugh at you. He's going to try to dishonor you. He's going to despise you for your step of faith. He will have contempt for you. He's going to conspire against you, and he's going to try and hinder you through people around you. And he's going to use family, friends, and foe to do this. Well, why does the enemy do this? Why does the enemy come against us? Why doesn't he come against us when we pray? Why doesn't he come against us when we read the word? Why doesn't he come against us when we go to church? Well, he does, but not like he does when we take steps of faith. For you see, when a man or a woman walks in faith with Jesus, they are a force to be reckoned with. I want to say that again. Somebody didn't get that. When a man or a woman walks in faith with the Lord Jesus Christ, they are a force to be reckoned with because he or she is someone to be feared.
Amen.
Because you and God, listen to me, you and God make up a majority. You and God make up an unstoppable force. Can somebody hear me today?
Amen.
Satan and his demonic forces, they are afraid of a person who walks in faith with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And his fear makes him angry. See, because he wants us to believe that he's afraid of nothing. He wants us to believe that he is the unstoppable one. And he's not. And he begins to fear us, and his fear makes him angry. He's angry at us for walking in faith, but more than that, he's angry with himself for being afraid. Amen?
Amen?
And he begins to lash out. He begins to do things to try to stop us from going forth the task God put in front of us. Am I making sense to anybody this morning? Say amen.
Amen.
In Nehemiah 2, verse number 19, it says, "Then I came to the governors beyond the river and gave them the king's letters. Now the king had sent captains of the army and horsemen with me. But when Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the servant and the Ammonite and Geshem the Arabian heard it, they laughed us to scorn and despised us." The enemy's going to start out by making fun of you.
Amen.
Any of you ever been made fun of for your faith in Jesus Christ because you're walking by faith and not by sight, because you're doing what the Lord calls you to do? I've been called some awful names. Amen. People saying, "You really believe all that stuff," and laugh at me. You know what? I believe every word that's in that word right there. Amen.
Amen.
If God says it, I believe it. That's all there is to it. You can laugh all you want. You can despise me all you want, but you're not hurting me. Amen.
Amen.
You're not hurting me. Nehemiah 4, 1 through 3. "But it came to pass that when Sanballat heard that we builded the wall, he was angry." See, the enemy gets angry. "And took great indignation and mocked the Jews." The Bible teaches us that in these last days, there's going to be mockers that are going to rise. Amen? There's going to be mockers in these last days that mock the Lord, that mock the people of the Lord. "And he spoke before his brethren, the army of Samaria, and said, What do these feeble Jews?" Let me tell you something. We may be weak in stature. We may be weak in physical strength, but we're strong in the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
The Lord God is our strength.
Yes.
I read a thing last week, and I posted it on my Facebook page, that real true faith is man's weakness dependent upon God's strength. Amen? We may be feeble, but our God is not. Can somebody agree with that today and say amen?
Amen?
Will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they make an end in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of rubbish which they have burned? I'm going to tell you something today. I don't care how far down it's been torn, there is always a remnant where God can raise up an army. Amen? Can somebody hear? Y'all ain't getting this morning. Amen. There is always a remnant God can use to raise up a mighty army. "Now Tobiah the Ammonite was by him, and he said, Even that which they builded, if a fox go up, he shall even break down their stone wall." Let me tell you something. Little is much with God.
Amen.
Come on now, little is much with God. When you turn it over to him, it may look like you don't have anything to work with, but God can take that little and turn it into much. Amen. God can use that mustard seed faith to remove mountains. God can use that mustard seed faith you have to bring you to victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. But you know what? You can't give up. When the enemy comes against you, don't give up. You must press on. For the Lord your God is with you. Do you hear me today? Don't let the fear of failure. See, that's what people are so afraid they're going to fail. People are so afraid that they don't have what it takes to carry out the task at hand. And that fear stops us dead in our tracks. Fear immobilizes us. Fear makes us give up. Fear makes us back up. Fear makes us timid. Some of you are too timid.
Amen.
Hello. You got to get bold for the Lord. Amen. You can't fear failure. You can't fear the contempt of others stopping you from trusting in the Lord your God. He will see you through to the end. And He will accomplish through you what He's called you to do. You will be successful if you don't give up and just trust in the Lord your God completely. Can somebody give Him a hand clap of praise in the house of God? Well, I want to look at a few things today that we can do when the enemy begins to pour out his scorn on us. Number one, you have to declare the victory through your God who has called you. You have to declare the victory through your God, through your faith in Him who has called you. You know, so oftentimes we get a negative outlook on things. We'll look at, did you think Nehemiah, he was a cupbearer. He was not a stonemason. He was not a leader of men in battle. He worked in the kitchen at the king's house. Can somebody hear me? Only thing he done was tote wine to the king. That's all he done. He was a wine steward. But yet still God called him to a mighty task. God called him to a task that was above his pay grade. Amen. Can somebody hear me? And so oftentimes when God begins to call us to a task, He'll call us to a task that's way above our ability to accomplish. Can somebody hear me today? And when we see it, the first thing we do is we say, I don't know if I can do that. Well, I got news for you today. If God's called you to it, God's going to take you to victory. Amen. God's going to make you succeed today. Can somebody hear me? We got to stop with the negative attitudes. Am I getting through to anybody today? It don't look like it. Amen. We got to stop with the negativity. We got to start getting positive because the Bible teaches us that we have the victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. Nehemiah 2:20. Then answered I them and said to them, the God of heaven. Do you hear that? He will prosper us. Therefore we His servants will arise and build. Can you hear me today? When God calls you to a task, He's not called you out to watch you fail. He's not called you out to watch you drown. He has not called you out to watch you lay down by the wayside and give up. He has called you to victory. Can somebody hear me today? He has called you to keep pressing on. Don't give up.
Thank you.
Boy, some of you, I wish I could just pick up and shake this morning. Amen. But you've got to get positive that you have the victory through your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. When Joseph was a slave, he prospered because of his faith in God. His brothers, they hated him. They couldn't stand him. They took him, beat him up, and threw him down in a well.
Amen.
And left him there to some slave traders come by, pulled the boy out, and sold him into slavery. And then those slave traders took him to Egypt and sold him as a slave to Potiphar.
That's right.
But you know what? It did not get Joseph down. Joseph kept his eyes focused on the Lord Jesus Christ. He kept his eyes focused on God. Amen. God had made him a promise. God had told him what He was going to do for him. And Joseph knew beyond a shadow of a doubt, no matter what, come what may, that he had the victory through the Lord his God. Amen. It says in Jesus 39:1-3, and Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites, which had brought him down thither. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. He was a man who was a slave. But yet and still, he was a prosperous man because the Lord's hand was with him. Amen? Because the Lord his God was lead, guide, and directing his life. Because Joseph would not take his eyes off the Lord. He would not get negative in his situation. Can somebody hear me today? I'm trying to get you to get your eyes on these things. Amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. So oftentimes when things begin to happen, the first thing we go is put our head down and go to get negative. Well, I thought this and I thought that. Well, oh God, why is this happening to me? Oh Lord, why am I a slave in captivity? Amen. No, you got to realize something. If God made you a promise, God's going to do it.
That's right.
Amen. You just got to do something. You got to pull up your cowboy boots, put on your big boy pants, and you've got to put your eyes on Jesus. Start walking by faith. Amen. Start trusting in him. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
You know, some of us want a blessing, but don't want to do anything for it. We don't want to take steps of faith. We'll beg God to bless us. We'll beg God to do things for us. And when God begins to do it, we make him all kind of promises. Is anybody in here ever done that before besides me? We'll make all kind of promises to God. And God began to bless us. But the minute we began to receive the blessings, we quit walking by faith. Can somebody hear me? And then we get negative when bad things go to happen. And we don't understand. It ain't God's fault. Ooh, boy, it got quiet in the house of God all of a sudden. Amen. It ain't God's fault.
Amen.
It's our fault. Amen. But I'm telling you something. When you keep your eyes on him, when you go where when he says go, when you do what he says do, when you walk where he tells you to walk, when you trust in him completely, you will always walk in victory, and everything you put your hand to will prosper. Amen. Can somebody hear me today? No matter where you are, no matter what your situation, because of your faith and obedience to God.
Thank you, God.
Can I say something? It's not about how you want to obey. It's how God wants you to obey. Am I talking to anybody here today? You know, so oftentimes we want to do it our way. We got an idea how things are supposed to be. We got an idea how things are supposed to go. And we want it our way. Hello? When it's not about what we want, it's not about our way, it's about God's way. Amen?
Amen.
Can you hear what I'm saying to you today?
Amen.
And I'm the world's worst about, you know, God tells me something, and he shows me where I want to walk, and I start going that way, and I start thinking about all these wonderful things, and I realize something. Before God can begin to pour out the blessing and the victory, I got the victory, amen?
Yeah.
I've already got it. I just gotta go through some. I gotta go through some boggy times, amen.
Amen.
I gotta go through a rainy season every now and then. That doesn't mean I'm doing anything wrong. That just means God's testing my faith. Am I talking to anybody in the house of God today?
Amen.
Woo! But we've got to realize that no matter what, God gives us the victory. 1 Corinthians 15:57. But thanks be to God which gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 2:14. Now thanks be unto God which always causes us to triumph in Christ. Did you hear what I said? Oh, come on now. Always causes us to triumph. Not sometimes, not one or two times, but always causes us to triumph in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
You know something? Before God can pour out the big blessing on us, we got to be faithful in the little blessings. Amen?
Amen.
Because how can he entrust us with a big blessing if we're not willing to take care of the little blessings first? Am I making sense to anybody? Say amen.
Amen.
But the word tells us we always, somebody say always,
always
triumph in the Lord Jesus Christ. So remember, when the enemy comes against you, you speak that victory to him. You tell him what the Lord has said for you. Amen. You tell him that you are victorious through your faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. If you agree with that, say amen.
Amen.
The second thing you need to know is this. God will supply for all your need to accomplish the task. Amen. When he calls, you think God's going to call you to something and not give you what you need to finish it? Hello? That's about like sending somebody to roof your house and not giving them hammer and nails. You give them shingles, you give them roofing paper, but you don't give them the hammer and nails to put them down with. What good is it? Amen? God is not going to, am I getting through to anybody this morning? If God sends you to a task, God's going to give you exactly what you need when you need it to accomplish the task.
Amen.
So don't let me hear you saying, well, I ain't never done that before. That's one of the biggest hindrances we run up on. Well, I can't handle it. I ain't never done that before. I can't do that. How many of you, we got any I can't do that's in the house? Come on, raise your hand. Let me see your hand. We got any, got two people that's honest with me this morning. The I can't do that people. Don't worry, y'all not the only two, amen. The rest of them would cowboy up. They'd raise their hand too, amen. I can't do that. I ain't never done that before. My daddy used to always say, can't die when do it come along.
That's right.
Hello, y'all got a hold of that then. Can't die when do it come along.
That's right.
Let me tell you something. You might not have ever done it before. You might not have ever experienced that before. You may not think you have what it takes. But when you're trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ and go ahead and take one step of faith, God will begin to pour out on you exactly what you need when you need it. Amen? You just got to start walking. Praise God. You know, I've lost 30 pounds. And since I've come to the church full time and trying to, you know, get the internet ministry up and running, trying to get the website going, trying to learn how to edit video and do all this stuff, I've been behind that desk a lot. And needless to say, some of that weight's began to creep back on me. And I know some of y'all looking at me this morning said, you've lost what? Where is it? Where'd it go? I don't see none gone. Don't take my word for it. I have. But because I haven't been up walking like I'm supposed to, some of them pounds are coming back. Amen. And I keep praying, Lord, you gotta continue to help me lose this weight. Lord, you gotta do this and you gotta do that. And the Lord looked at me one day and he spoke to me. He said, well, when you gonna get up off your lazy butt and do what you're supposed to do? Amen. Come on now.
Amen.
Sometimes you gotta just get up. Do what God's told you to do. Take a step of faith, and then God can begin to bless you. Amen. God can begin. Am I getting through to anybody this morning? Say amen.
Amen.
Hey, I'm not saying that we live a life of works. I'm not saying that. We live a life of faith. But you're the one that's got to take a step of faith. Hello? Because so oftentimes we want the blessing before we take a step of faith. We want to see the outcome before we take the step of faith. Well, it ain't going to work that way, child. Can you hear me today, brother? Can you hear me today, sister? It doesn't work that way. You've got to, everywhere in the Word, when people begin to take steps of faith, God began to bless. Amen. God began to supply what they needed when they needed it to accomplish the task. Am I getting through to anybody? Say amen.
Amen.
But God's going to give it to you, so don't sit there and say, well, I've never done that before. I can't do that. Well, guess what? You just stopped yourself cold.
Amen.
Nehemiah said in chapter 2, beginning with verse 7, moreover, I said unto the king, if it please the king, let letters be given to me. Let letters of authorization be given to me to the governors beyond the river, that they may convey me over till I come unto Judah. That they'll give me what I need to get this, to continue this journey. Amen. Guess what? God's authorized you. Can you hear me today? God has authorized you. You are a child of God today. You are a son or a daughter of the King today. And He is not going to leave you without what you need on your journey. Can somebody hear me today? Now, am I getting through to you? Say amen.
Amen.
And a letter unto Asaph, the keeper of the king's forest, that he may give me timber to make beams for the gates of the palace, which are appropriated to the house, and for the wall of the city, and for the house that I shall enter into. And the king granted me, listen, according to the good hand of God upon me. When God's with you, you'll have everything you need to accomplish that. Psalms 23:1 says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Now everybody can quote that scripture. But do you realize what that last part means? I shall not want. It means you shall not have need. Because God's going to give you what you need when you need it. Amen. Not before, not too early, and not too late. 2 Corinthians 9:8 says, and God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things. In other words, because of God's grace. Come on now, one person got a hold of that. Because of God's grace, you're going to have sufficiency. You're going to have what you need that you may abound to every good work. Philippians 4:19 says, my God shall supply for your needs according to His riches in glory. His riches in glory begins with His grace, amen. Because of His grace, you're going to have what you need. The third thing you need to know is this, and this is a biggie. Don't let fear. Don't let fear cloud your mind or control your actions or emotions. See, we're bad children. We're bad children of God. Of letting fear get a hold of us and hold us back. Amen?
Amen.
We look at the strength of the enemy. We hear the mocking. We hear the scornful laughter. We see them coming against us, and the first thing we do is want to go hide up under the bed somewhere. Amen? I'm telling you what, we can't do that because, you know what, fear immobilizes the child of God when they allow it control. Am I making sense to you? Amen.
Amen.
Fear will cloud your mind and stop you from believing God. Nehemiah 4:14, and I looked up and rose up and said unto the nobles and to the rulers and the rest of the people, be not ye afraid of them. Remember the Lord, which is great and terrible. In other words, remember the Lord who is all powerful. Remember the Lord who's brought you this far. Remember the Lord who can do anything. Remember the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Remember the Lord that nothing is impossible for, amen. We don't remember who God is sometimes. We let that fear come in and we forget who we serve. We serve the Lord God Almighty. Amen? We serve El Shaddai. We serve a God that nothing's impossible for. We serve a God who has not given us the spirit of fear.
Thank you, God.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power. That is the power to walk by faith and not by sight. Amen?
Amen.
That is the power to walk by faith and not by sight. And of love. You know what?
Yeah.
Love covers a multitude of sins. Amen?
Amen.
And of a sound mind. To get our mind focused on Jesus. As He thinks in his heart, so is he. What's your mind focused on? Hello? What's your mind focused on? It's got to be focused on Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
It's got to be focused on Him completely. Hello? Not on the Super Bowl. Look, I have to fight against this. Not on hunting and fishing. Amen. Oh, Lord, I dread turkey season every year. I love to turkey hunt. Amen. But I have to be careful because I'll get so focused on hunting season, on turkey. Don't look at me like I'm crazy. You ain't never, you ever tried it, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's very addictive, amen? I get so focused on turkey hunting that I lose focus on what God's calling me to do. See, so I have to be careful. God's got to be first.
Amen.
Am I getting through to anybody? See, I'm telling on myself, and everybody's looking at me like I'm some kind of freak or something, amen? But I'm trying to be honest with you, amen?
Amen.
Because guess what? There's some things in your life. There's, hello, is everybody listening to the preacher say amen?
Amen.
There's some things in your life that you get so focused on that you make God take a back seat to in your life.
Amen.
Boy, there's some head down, won't nobody look at me, amen. I'm telling the truth to you today, but if you'll focus on God, fear can't control your mind. God has given you a sound mind to be focused on Him. And guess what? If God is for you, who can stand against you? Amen. Because greater is He that's in you than he that's in the world. Glory to God. Can somebody give Him praise in the house today? You see, when fear comes in, we begin to run. And we run where there's no need to be running. When we need to be standing our ground, holding steadfastly on our faith. We need to be bold for God. Because you know what? When we do that, God will make the enemy flee. He'll make the enemy fall before you. Amen? Proverbs 28:1. The wicked flee. In other words, the sinful flee when no man pursues, but the righteous are bold as a lion. Psalm 68:1. Let God arise. Let His enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate Him flee before Him. The enemy will flee before you because you know what? God is going to fight that battle for you. Amen?
Praise God.
Only thing you got to do is don't run. Lord, give me the words. Sometimes a human being, the least little bit of boogery sound, comes. Somebody can holler boo and they turn around and run. We got any scaredy cats like that in here today? Don't raise your hand. But some of us do. At least some of us, the wind can blow wrong and we'll take off running. We see boogers everywhere, amen? We jump at shadows when there's no need to be running. Because if God is with you, God will put the enemy to flight before you. Guess what, church? You have what it takes through your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ to stand your ground and not run. The enemy will flee from you because Jesus will fight your battle. And He has given you all you need to stand boldly before the enemy. Psalm 91, it said, He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. In Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover me. He shall cover you with His wings, and under His wings shall you trust. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor by the arrow that flies by day, nor by the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor for the destruction that waits at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near to you. Only with your eyes shall you behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because the Lord has made you, because you have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation. Because you have made the Lord your God your life, amen? You have put Him first and foremost. You are concentrated on Him, and that enemy will fall before you. You don't have to run, amen? Can somebody hear me today? Be strong in the Lord and the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand, hold your ground, and win the victory against the wiles of the devil. Quit letting fear control you. Quit running when there's no need to run. The next thing you need to know is this. Because of your faith in Jesus, because of your dependency on Jesus, He will fight your battle for you. And all you got to do is just show up. Hello, you know, this is a hard concept for us to understand. Just showing up. You know, we're a do-oriented society. Amen. Got to do this and got to do that. Well, sometimes you just need to be still and know that He's God.
Amen.
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 Sometimes you just need to know that those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, shall mount up on wings like eagles, shall run and not be weary, shall walk and not faint. Amen.
Thank you, God.
Sometimes all the thing you got to do is come on, somebody give Him praise in the house of God. You just got to show up. God does the rest. Amen. Nehemiah says this, in what place therefore ye hear the sound of the trumpet, resort ye thither unto us, our God shall fight for us. Nehemiah 4:20. Our God shall fight for us. When Moses and the Israelites were backed up to the Red Sea, and Pharaoh and the armies of Egypt would come and get them, was coming to attack them, what did Moses tell the people? He said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord.
Yeah.
And which He will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you will see again no more forever. Oh, Lord God said, I'm gonna take care of this for you. Amen. And only thing you gotta do is watch. How? Come on, somebody. Only thing you gotta do is watch. Only thing you gotta do is stand back and trust Him. All you gotta do is get your eyes on Him. Hold up the banner, glory to God, and He will fight the battle and bring you victory today. Can somebody give Him praise in the house of God? When a multitude of enemies came against Jehoshaphat and the Israelites at Jerusalem, listen to what the Lord sent them word to do. He said, then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehazahel, the son of Zechariah, and He said, listen, all of you Judah and you inhabitants of Jerusalem, and you, King Jehoshaphat, thus said the Lord to you, do not be afraid nor dismayed because of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God. You will not need to fight in this battle. Listen, position yourself, stand still. In other words, the only thing you got to do is show up. Amen? And you know what you got to carry with you? Your faith. Hello? And it ain't that heavy because it's only got to be as big as a grain of a mustard seed. Amen? Am I getting through to anybody right now? Say amen.
Amen.
Only thing you got to do is show up, position yourself, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord. Who is with you, O Judah and Jerusalem? Do not fear or be dismayed. Some of you are worry warts. You worry about everything. Amen? You get bent out of shape. You let a bill come in you thought you'd paid two weeks ago come in that you accidentally forgot and left undone. You let a reminder come in, you go crazy. Go doing backflips, amen. Quit worrying. God's gonna take care of it for you, amen. Who of you by worry can add one cubit to your stature? Let me ask you something. I want you to answer me very carefully now. Has God let you down so far?
Nope.
How many times have you let God down?
Once.
But has He always been there for you when you needed Him?
Yes.
Hello, yes He has.
Thank you, God.
He'll never leave you nor forsake you. He will fight those battles for you when you put your eyes on Him. He goes on to say there in 2 Chronicles 20, tomorrow go down against them. He done told them to just go position yourself in the battle. Don't be afraid and dismayed. Just go tomorrow, go out against them for the Lord. Somebody say the Lord.
The Lord.
For the Lord is with you. He's going to fight the battle for you. He will be with you in your time of need, and He will fight that battle for you as well. Hebrews 13:5-6, let your conduct be without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have. Contentment.
Amen.
Ooh, I could bring a whole message on that. Some of you want to. You know, there's a difference between want and need.
Yes.
I can't tell you what my daddy used to say about that, but you can imagine, amen. My mama used to always tell me, said, you ain't too big for your wants to hurt you, amen. And I've learned this, if I've done without it this long, I can do without a little bit more, amen.
Amen.
We got to learn to be content. And we get content through the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Contentment only comes through Him. As Spirit, let your conduct be without covetousness, be content with such things you have. For He Himself has said, Jesus Christ Himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me? 2 Chronicles 32:8. With Him is an arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. Church, I want to assure you this morning, I want you to hear me today, that you will accomplish your task when God is leading the way. You just got to give Him rein. Amen.
Amen. That's right.
You got to let Him drive. There's too many of us wanting to drive. You know, we have a hard time, and I'm the world's worst about this, I reckon. I've done it for so long myself. It's hard for me to let somebody else do it for me. Am I talking to anybody in the house of God today? But see, God wants to do it for you. And when we'll just let go and let God. When we give Him control. When we let Him fight the battle. When we let Him supply for our needs. When we receive the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. You will accomplish your task which God is leading you to. He'll take you all the way. Nehemiah 6:15-16 said, so the wall was finished. I like that. So the wall was finished. They accomplished what God had called them to do. And guess what, church? All the odds were against them. The government was against them. See, that's what Sanballat was. Sanballat was the governor of the region. And he was against them. All his cronies was against them. Am I making sense to anybody today?
Amen.
But they didn't listen to what they were saying. They listened to the Lord their God. They trusted in Him completely. They put their eyes on Him and the wall was finished. And in the last part of verse 16 said this, and he's talking about Sanballat and Tobiah and all those people here. For they perceived that this work was done by our God. You see, when you let go and you let God and you trust in Him completely, when you do these things we've talked about this morning, people are going to know that it's God done it in your life. Amen. And He's going to receive honor and glory. Let me ask you something this morning. Are you willing to give Him control? Brother Ronnie, come on. Are you willing to let Him do what He's got to do to see you through the victory today? And some of you might be facing a task right now that you're looking at it and you're saying, I don't know if I can do that. Well, if God's called you to it, He'll see you through it. If you'll just put your eyes on Him, He's promised you the victory. He'll accomplish what He's called you to if you'll just let Him. You just got to take the steps of faith.
Amen.
And let Him do what you've got to do. All heads are bowed. All eyes are closed. There's nobody looking around. What are you struggling with today? What are you facing? Are you facing a task that's greater than you are? Are you facing something you've never had experience before? And you're struggling right now. You don't know what you're going to do. Well, I tell you what you're going to do. You're going to turn it over to the Lord.
Amen.
You're going to give Him control. Because you know what? He calls you out to watch you drown. He's going to give you victory today. He's going to supply exactly what you need to accomplish your task. He's going to give you the power to put your eyes on Him and walk by faith and not by sight. He is going to fight your battle for you. And He's going to accomplish the task. You just got to show up. Are you willing just to show up and let go and let God do that? We're going to take a few minutes. We're going to open up these altars. Whatever your need today, come. Lift it up to the Lord. Give Him control. Take one step of faith. One step of faith, and God's going to meet you. Won't you come? Won't you come?